Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. This video is the continuation of my previous video, NOR gate design using full custom flow. Now in this video we'll generate layout and we'll do the post layout simulation of it. As in my last video, see, this is the schematic that I have created, and with this schematic we will proceed. So for that we have to go file, new, cell view, and create a cell view that is suppose NOR, and in the type it should be layout. You can take anything, layout L, or if you take XL or GXL then it is the advanced version. So we can take layout XL or GXL. So once this window comes, we can go for settings first, then this will all depends upon the foundry. Then go for the editor and show alignment marker, then options, DRD edit, then just check this, just check this and click OK. So now we can do by two ways. One is to take the instances from the technology library, or we can make the layout from directly from the schematic. So it depends on the designer how he wants to continue. But as in our last video I have already created my schematic, so I will continue with the schematic. So for that I have to go for connectivity, generate all from source, that is like we will be hiring all my instances from the schematic. And then these are the settings, IOPINs. And if you want to change the width and all, so you can change it from here. Okay, so see, this is the transistors and it is the active area, okay, in which we will be doing our floor planning. So first of all, this active area I have to select according to our design. So and see, these are the pins that we have created in the schematic. So all the instances and pins has arrived. Now we have to drag it to the active area. So once we have dragged it, yes, so just drag, see, some our boundary is not sufficient for placing all the instances, okay, because there will be some more space needed for the routing also. So just according to your design, try to make the boundary settings. I'll show you how to do the boundary setting. Go to the object menu, then here we'll check the boundaries, then stretch, and then just stretch the boundaries. See, now have sufficient space for routing, so we can easily route our layers. So make the orientation good so that it's look good. So in the above there are two PMOS type transistors, and in downside there are two n-type and transistors. Now go to properties, parameters. See, yes, I'm adding the substrate. I've selected my first PMOS type transistors. Then see, in the left substrate will be created. In the same way I will choose the second transistor, then I'm giving right, yes, and then so substrate will be created in the right side. So this is the NMOS I have chosen. Now in the left substrate will be created, then again right substrate will be created. So I have make the instance complete. Ground, sorry, we did drain source, gate and bulk. Now see, these are the pins that came from schematic. We can manually, we can take it from schematic, or we can manually place the pins. So pin placement, then ground. Suppose we are giving for ground, so attributes you can choose. Suppose this is a ground, so we will choose as bottom. So and the layer, what in which you want to draw the routing. So M1 draw, then apply. So see, ground pin has created. Now we need a rail, right? So because to make a rail, after making rail only we can do the routing and also we have made the rail. Next I'm going for input one. So as the as normal convention, inputs are in left side and so outputs are in right side. So we are giving in left, again for the second input also I'm doing same, input left, then out, it will be on right side. So right, then VDD will be in topmost. So same thing, M1 will be doing routing by M1 layer. So then again we will create a rail in for VDD. So see, VDD rail has been created, and these are the pins, left pin, input 1, input 2, and in right side there is a out pin. And one more thing I want to add, these are the schematic, the transistors are in schematic, so you can use gate, drain as source and source as drain. Now we have to do the routing according to our schematic. This is the gate. I'm connecting gate of PMOS and NMOS. See, if the alignment is not correct, then there might come DRC error. So to keep the thing simple and DRC free, do a proper alignment. Now connect the gate to VDD, substrate to VDD, then again connect the substrate to VDD, then connect the NMOS substrate to VSS. Now see, now I have placed my input pins to the leftmost, and I will draw a layer to the first transistor, PMOS transistor. Red one is a poly layer and blue one is a metal layer. So I will create a via so that it can make a transistor and it can connect. Fine. So I have created one via and I have placed it. Now see, I'm doing the same thing for the second transistor also. Again I am making one via and I am taking metal poly layer out of it. See, this is not short circuit, okay, because a poly layer and metal layer can't be short circuited. So we can draw a metal layer over the poly layer, so not an issue. Now for the output pin, output will be taking from this pin. These are the just simple routing according to your schematic. So just do the check and save. Check whether any layers have been left for routing. See, in this video I am intentionally leaving one routing layers, like I have not connected one routing layers, because to show you how to overcome it in the verification process. Okay, so these are the pins that I have to level. So I am giving IN1, IN2, VDD, ground and out. Okay, so as I have make the routing in metal one, so I have to give the metal one level in the metal one layers. Fine, so leveling has been done. So I will do the verification is in my next video. So keep watching the